Hello everyone and welcome back to the Road to Division 1 series. Now, in light of the latest episode that has come out, I need to talk about some stuff first and foremost. Because pretty much the last episode that I did record, I'm not going to upload because exact same thing happened, as you can see. So annoying. On the bottom three records, I've actually lost my last three games, haven't won my previous three. Well, yeah, that last episode that I recorded a few days ago was identical to the one that was last uploaded, where I played two games, one game in theory, and that was on one latency. So basically I've been having problems with the connection recently. Now I think I've sorted it out now. I've started a couple of games, then backed out once I found my opponent, and I have three latency instead of one. So as you can see, like last episode, I got into a game that was on one latency. Last episode that was uploaded, so my fourth to last game in here, I actually won the one latency game 2-1. The last time I got on it against that Mustavit guy in the middle, I actually lost that 1-1-0. I didn't bother uploading because it was just the same as last video. It was 50 minutes of me just trying to get into games, then out of games, then restarting the game, trying to sort my connection and this and that. And I just don't know what was happening. Perhaps it was EA's fault. Perhaps my servers weren't quite up to scratch. But it was just pointless uploading because I had the exact same problem. I played this guy. As I said, he won. He deserved that one, to be fair to him. But just like the DNF on the right there, I did not finish on the left. Eventually, after about 25 minutes after playing Must Have It, I finally got into finding an opponent again. And I just thought, you know, because at times it wasn't even let me find an opponent, just said no opponent could be found. So I got onto the opponent, I had one latency, so I thought, fuck it, I'll just click on it, I'll play the game. And like the one on the far right hand corner, the DNF there, I got the opponent, it got to the teams set up, like last episode uploaded, and it froze. So I sat there, seriously, for 5 minutes. I was getting really annoyed, I was starting to like curse and stuff, so literally a mirror episode twice there. So it's a shame I couldn't upload the Must Have It game. It's the only game I've actually played so far in this series that didn't upload. But yeah, the video was just pointless, really. It was 50 to 55 minutes of me just battling with the servers. So we've established that now. It's annoying that I've not been able to play two games this season. So in reality, I actually have 9 points from 8 games. From 6 games. I'm on 8 games now. So, 9 points from that. It leaves me now with 2 games remaining, needing 3 for promotion and 2 wins out of 2 for the title. Just so annoying. I mean, them 2 games I couldn't play, I might well have actually lost anyway. But, you know, the worst I could do is keep the record as that. And avoiding 2-3-0 defeats for games I didn't even play has really seriously hurt my record, which is so irritating. And you can see what I mean there. It says mealtime record is 12-1-9. Well, up at the top it's saying 16-1-14 in games that I haven't even actually played. It really is irritating me, that. So let's put the pressure on this. But as I said, touch wood. I think the server connection should be better now. And hopefully it is the case, because I'd say this, there's no way in hell I'm going to start a game where I have one latency again, because that is an issue. You know, I'd advise anyone watching this to not do that, because twice out of 4 games now with the one latency, it just froze on my opponent's team screen. And as well as that, I think my opponents have the same issue. So as you can see now, we do have 3 latency again, thank God. Well, it's went down to 2 then, but back on 3. So for the first, oh, he's got a classic Liverpool kit. I've got to go Liverpool then, innit? Go on, lad. We're repping all Liverpool here. This guy's got the classic down. I might actually use that. I have got the classic. I'm pretty sure I bought it the other day. So I might go full Liverpool kit after this game. But as I said, it's just going to be good to play a game that doesn't have any lag. The last game I did play was really bad for it as well. You know, the guy beat me 1-0, as I said. He did deserve it. He was the better player. He managed to lag better. And the one previously in the lag, I managed to win 2-1. Well, that lag in the last episode that was uploaded, because in reality it was the second to last episode I recorded. It was bad, but it was manageable. The last game was just ridiculous. It took about 17 minutes if you play the game. So finally we're back in good connection. I've sort of unplugged the Wi-Fi, plugged it in again, reset the Xbox, and it seems to have done the trick, thankfully. So yeah, never really had many Wi-Fi issues in the past, but thankfully it sort of seems to have sorted itself now. So apologies, it had to be a long intro, just sort of explain why, for one, I haven't really uploaded much recently, and certainly online, and for two, why my record saying that I did not finish again. So, of course, I would rather this happen on an earlier division, if it's ever going to happen, I suppose. I'm going to definitely retain the division, but of course, I would like promotion, and now there's pressure in this game. So a full explanation done. I didn't really have time to go through these opponents' teams. So you can see where he's not a Premier League team. He's got a Serie A setup that looks pretty strong, actually. It's a pretty solid team he's got there. Oh, it's a lovely turn there. Dodge. Tackle by Van Perisic onto Coleman. Now we look inside. So a lot of his players I did recognise. We've got the name tags on, of course, to spot them, so... Yeah, just back to commentary now. As the goal kick isn't great to Kante, De Bruyne has picked it up. Lamella's just going to bang it. Making his debut here today, Eric Lamella. That's another annoying aspect, actually. Like, they did not finish. The one that was, I think, on the last record, I think it was my Premier League team, and we actually lost a game or two for Hector Bellerin, perhaps, and Riyad Mahrez, I think it was. Well, the last game that did not finish me, that I tried, I'm pretty sure I used my Spanish team, so we actually lost James Rodriguez on a loan. I might be mixing it up there. You know, the last video I uploaded, oh, it's a lovely ball, that, to Dimitri Payet. Just have to break off because we're in serious attacking. Spot here. As D looks for it. Studge keeps it in. Oh, Lamella. Get on that shit. We're all over this guy early days. Dimitri. Good effort. Safe. Tipped over by Kinesis. And I feel like I've got the better of this guy if I keep this up. So, I had to break off, of course, because we're on attack, but as I was saying, we lost Riyad Mahrez and James Rodriguez, who had one game left, because of the fact that it counted it as a game, which is really irritating, but thankfully, I packed Eric Lamella, so he's just a perfectly timed pack. Oh, I tried to fake shot inside there with Kevin De Bruyne. That one's going to be forgotten really quickly, because that was terrible. But now we do have a game that's flowing again. We've started this match reasonably well, I think. This guy's not all that, I don't think, to be honest. He's struggling so far. But we do still need to be wary, because I haven't really seen him in attack yet, so he might have a little bit of prowess there as he gets the ball to Parolo. Alexandro is fed Ivan Perisic. Great block there by Seamus Coleman. I thought that might have bumped back off Perisic, but apparently not. Well, Coleman's picked up. Eric Lamella. Oh, it's a terrible ball by Lamella. He looked for Kante. And he's spread over to Kwadwo-Asamoah. He bangs it over. Oh, terrible kick out as well to Ivan. It's Adair, who we have in this squad as well, actually. Still yet to really use Adair because we have Dybala on loan, but the stats are actually really good on it. So we need to be careful when Adair's on the ball. It's Kante. Love that N'Golo, because he's fed De Bruyne. Now Studge. So Eric looks inside. We've won a free kick there in an advanced position. As the booking comes out for Murillo of Internazionale. So I could shoot. I'm actually just going to look to whip this one in, I think. I'll tell you what, this guy's playing off. My players have just gone forward. Why not try this? It doesn't go to the keeper. It's Wick. It's Rom. Oh my god. Kevin. Almost got on the end of his Belgian teammate's pass. Slash shot. So yeah, as I said, I mean earlier, this is really promising. The connection's back, so we're a few grey areas for a few days in terms of internet connection. So it's good to see us back in the mix. As Dimitri picks it up, he's been tackled though. Yeah, this guy really is struggling with pressure. I feel like I should be winning this already, and I will not see this as a good point if we even draw this game, to be honest, because it would be a definite opportunity miss. That's clearly offside for Studge. So Alexandro with the free kick for these guys. Yeah, it's going to press this man, but there's a guy in Akers in the bottom. I did see him, but too late. It's Ivan Perisic who picks up the ball. It's Gabbiadini, now Parolo. He's found a great ball to Cuadrado. He's really quick, not going to catch him. He's fed into it there. Oh my god. First sign of attack for this guy. So defensively, he does look a bit suspect at times, but certainly offensively there, yeah. He got into a situation where he should really have scored, to be honest. But Sturridge onto Eric. Make stuff happen, Eric. Yes, done. Karius is it out, Kevin. Oh my god, it took a deflection off my own player. Now Kolarov's going to bang it. Alex, off the... Oh, it's followed in by Ron though. Get in, come on. So that was a great strike by Kolarov. And off the post, and Romelu Lukaku was alert to the danger. And that was a tap in, if ever there is one. So get in. All is forgotten if the internet connection being so bad does get us promotion, because I suppose the title win will be big, but of course the one I wanted is this one win to get promotion. The title win in Division 8 I think gets you about 3,000 coins, something like that, I'm going to guess. So it's decent, of course, not to be passed over, but it's not like proper devastating if I miss out on that. So gonna win here, we'll take off the pressure in the next game, of course, and we can just go all out for the title. And right now we are looking dangerous, because Derek looks his dodge onto Infant De Bruyne. Oh, Kevin, lovely from you. Lamella, it's offside, I think. Yeah, just about. Romelu was in space, fortunately, but this guy can't handle us defensively, I feel, and I think we look more likely to score next. And this might be it. Oh no, Kevin. Lukaku just stopped the wrong timer. So Lamella. Kante's been caught there, but Mustafi's on that shit. And Kante stayed down, unfortunately. Studge. Onto De Bruyne. Now Rom. Oh, saved by Kinesis. Decent football, boys. We were whipped in by De Bruyne. Mustafi's there. Oh, lucky squadron. So, and it's going to be half time, sure enough. As soon as I said it, it is. And yeah, we've been completely dominant this game. 9 shots, 6 on target, to his 2 and 0. As I said, there's the danger, it's still 1-0, that he will get a goal on the break, but this guy's in Division 8 for a reason. I just don't think it's because it's early days, like hopefully it is for us, because we are going to get promoted for days like this. I would not be surprised if this guy's played 50 times and he's still in Division 8, because he's not particularly good, to be honest. As we go in the attack again, we're going to show that, because De Bruyne's giving it to Coleman. Coleman holds it up. He's found Eric. He's going to whip it in. Rom! Oh my god. The defenders just did fuck all, but it was a yard in front of Rom, unfortunately. I don't know why he's watching all these replays, I'll be honest. You know, it's your own time, you waste them, mate. You need to get back in the game, not me. He's doing it again. Has this guy's controller run out, props? Because if it does, it's easy pickings. No, he has flicked it on, so I do not know what he's doing. I hate people who do that, I'll be honest. Gets his foot in there. They just watch every replay, you know. I skip everyone, generally, even if I score. Well read by the defender. Kante. Kevin. Go on, Kev. He's found one. Oh, Bloody hell. Almost got in again anyway, but I was looking to hold that up for a split second to feed Kevin back in, but he made a crucial tackle there. Now it's Cuadrado. Manolo Gabbiadini. Looked inside, but not as far as Kante. This guy is really, really struggling. As Payet comes away. He's fed collar off, but Florenzi sees it out. Yeah, carrying your own there, Payet. No, instead I'll feed it to Lukaku then, who goes inside for Kante, who can bang these. Oh, he did as well. Good save, I can use this. I said in my last video, I played a few offline games on a tournament, and Kante scored an absolute worldie. Bye! Went for the header, and this guy's just dog shit. He's dawdled heavily on the defending, trying to get it clear, and there's Skodran Mustafi for his first goal for the club with the timely tackle. So it is my strongest team I'm using, to be fair, because I have to. There's no room for error if we do want the title, of course, but really this is probably it's easily the easiest game I've had so far on this Ultimate Team series against this guy. Oh, I've got another injury. And that's so unfortunate in the scope of the game, because it's allowed to Asmos just get completely clear. This would be such an undeserved goal. I do not fucking believe that. That is so lucky. He's had one shot on target, scored it. Look, shit back. Like, we get the play up top, and I'm not going to see the replay, am I? I mean, he'll watch the shit out of this replay. Of course he will. When I skip both of mine. Get to see for it. Yeah, he slid in for the ball. Coleman's beaten him to it. Has fell over this guy's feet and got himself injured. And of course, Asamoah is in Akers then, and I'm not going to catch it. There is the injury to Seamus Coleman, so I think we've got two players we're going to have to apply fitness cards to. And this is a completely undeserved route back into the game for him there. Is Ivan Perisic. It's injured this guy's players. He can. So Sandro's got in genuinely this time. That was a good pass by him there. He's cut back. What can Alexandro do? Mustafi, Coleman. Lamella gets rid. No, Kante. He's going to feed it to Kevin. Lucky Kev. Looking for Lukaku there. It's Cuadrado. This guy's definitely got more attacking, so I might set tactics to counter-attack in a second. He's giving it to Gabbiadini. Great tackle there by Bai. Oh my god. What an effort that was. Well, it was an awkward-looking save from what's his name? Karius. But saying the opponent's not great, but credit to him there, actually. That was a great attempt. It's a good ball through. It's Kevin. Lamella, sorry. Feeds Rom. Oh, what a block that is by Koulibaly. As we look to finish him off there. They're going to play it short. De Bruyne gives to Payet. Dimitri. Looking inside. Found its way to Marco Pirlo, now Adair. It's Asamoah. Cuadrado's and Akers there. I do need to be careful. I feel pressured now more in the attack, just because he got that jammy route back into the game. And there's Perisic. I'll be absolutely devastated if I don't beat this guy, I swear to God. De Bruyne. Lamella. One Eric. Hold that. Oh, he has done. Looking inside, but it's Koulibaly now. Asamoah returns. Pirlo. Gabbiadini. Florenzi. Terrible ball, though. It's found Dimitri Payet, who almost gave it away, though. Keep it steady, Dimitri. It's Lukaku. De Bruyne finds Dimitri. Now he can get forward. Still Payet. Oh, he looks for Rom. If I find him now, it's Florenzi clears. To Marco Pirlo. Looks inside to Gabbiadini. They get men forward, but they're giving it away cheaply as Kevin picks it up. Now it's Rom. Where's the support for Rom? That's got to be another foul. Who's this guy? He's injuring all my players, man. So I'm just going to go for a ridiculously ambitious one now, actually. I'm just going to bang it with Kevin. See what we can do. De Bruyne! Got a foot over the top in the end. But it's pretty central anyway. I think Kinesis was always going to deal with that. Dirty looks, says Alan Smith, for Kevin. He's had a decent game though, so forgive him. It's got to be Deeney. Barolo. And for the ambitious one. Karius is there. Oh, and looks to play this out. Kante finds Kevin. Feeds it to Dimitri. Now there goes Rom. It's Lukaku. Great turn by Lukaku. Oh, and he looks inside. To Dimitri. Oh, he should have finished it there, Dimitri. Win now, head to Eric. That'll do. De Bruyne. Lukaku. Great ball. To Sturridge. Who can finish things now? Oh, save by Kinesis. Clearance is almost picked up. Go on, Kev. Oh my god. He's filling over Lukaku. Cuadrado. Abidini. He's going to have to park the bus now for the last few minutes because this guy is on all out attack, I think. So he could kill us by numbers. Oh my god, he's got a corner last minute. Seriously, no attacking threat, really. Bar two shots from distance. He's only had one shot on target. Scored there. But this is dangerous. If I there. Get rid, lads. Fuck me. Hello, bye-bye. And there goes Kante. There is the final whistle then. I mean, it would have been a complete injustice, to be honest, if we failed to win that game. But at times, later on, he did do much better when he was on auto-attack. However, we always looked a threat going forward. And as I said, I think that's a deserved win. With Romelu Lukaku, the man of the match, played an 8.6 there. And Kevin and Coleman... Mustafi was second with an 8.3. As a result of them getting the two goals, two assists, we didn't have any, actually. I tackled one guy to get one, and Kolarov was unlucky, I suppose, to not get the assist, because he pretty much laid it on the plate for Lukaku with the post hit. But you see what I mean, 15 shots, 10 on target, he had 6 and 4, and as I said, two of his shots on target were from distance, so no pot shots. We have gained promotion. Said it's something of relief, seeing as we were deprived of being able to play two games with the dead not finish before we even started. So it's 12 points from 21 from the games we've been able to play. Still need to improve in future divisions, certainly from 7 onwards, but as I said, I usually play at Division 2 on average most of the time on 16. So I'm hoping I'll reach at least that on this game. And hopefully now we arrive in Division 7 on a high with a title win. So Daniel Sturridge needs contracts, and I'm going to give him the max available, of course. He hasn't actually been given a card yet as well, so that's important. We'll get him on this. Hawk looks good to me, to be honest. Two up in pace, so it'll be 91 pace, 81 dribbling, 85 shooting and 72 physical. He's pretty much a beast with this. And sure enough, he was a bit of a mentalist, that guy. He slid in a lot and he has injured two of my players. So it's really annoying that I'm going to have to waste on all injuries now on Kante, but has to be done. Kante's back. Let's check on Seamus then. He's a injured his leg for two matches. Right, we do have a heel. Fair enough. I was close to saying Coleman might be able to sit out if we played Bellerin, but I'm most probably going to use Hector Bellerin for my Spanish team because Danny Carvajal's running out, and I'm using him for my La Liga team right now. So speaking of, I still haven't actually... I said this in the last video I recorded, of course, but we couldn't play it because obviously the lag was shocking and shit. I had not televised the game, by televised of course, uploaded a match where I've played as a Spas yet. So this will be the first Informa Spas, who I did purchase on. I have played before on that tournament. I was playing offline. So yeah, hopefully he makes an impact now on what is his debut for the series. For contracts to give for some of these guys, the two players have just done are not gonna be there too much longer, I don't think, to be honest. The left mid and the right mid, Johnny and Vitolo, but certainly Marcelo and Rafa Varane, and I think the other one was Mazza. No, Mazza's okay. Well, Marcelo and Varane are gonna be involved for quite some time, so I'll give them max contracts there. All right, the other one was Diego Lopez, so I'm not sure if a replacement. Let's just have a quick check on my keepers. The only one was Roberto, so it is worth giving Lopez some contracts extension then. I'm not going to give him a card though, because I do feel like he's replaceable fairly soon. Within maybe it might be 5 games, might be 10 games, but looking at improving this setup, obviously the left mid and the right mid are probably going to be next. I don't mind Vitolo, he's really good, but I do prefer my rare cards, and certainly physically he's not quite as beasty as someone else could be. But yeah, I do think that long term Lopez isn't going to be staying here as well. The defence is looking decent, so I actually mentioned this last video, but of course couldn't upload, so I'll say it again. I'm going to buy Carvajal again, I think, after these two games are up, because he's actually quite cheap. He really isn't like a player that you have to break the bank for, I think. 2,000 to 3,000 might be enough to get Danny Carvajal in, so I've quite liked the feel of him so far, and I'm definitely looking at utilising him once more on a more permanent basis. So the defence is looking pretty solid, actually. I do quite like this one on the whole, and we certainly have greater firepower now with Inform Iago. So after last time, as I said, well, I'll just go through this team first, actually. So he has Depay, Remy and Sané. It's a rapid front three, that. Herrera, Schweinsteiger, Ramsey, Alberto Moreno, Matip, Mustafi, Bellerin and Karius. So pretty solid team there for Jürgen Klopp and manager as well. But I was saying before this popped up, of course, we have no James now in mid, so we've brought Angel Fernandez in, the Argentinian from Atletico Madrid. So he makes what may well be his series debut. I'm not sure if I've used him before, but I'm pretty sure I haven't. So let's hope he manages to get involved. Ferran, Vitolo. Great ball up by Vitolo there. He's found. It's actually Augusto Fernandez. Sorry, I think I called him Angel. Great ball in. Angel. Oh, it's pass. A save by Lloris. Could have been a lightning start there. I think we're going to play this short, actually. I'm going to hold it in and whip it in like that. Oh, it nearly worked. This guy's cleared it to Remy, who's rapid. Do not want him running against one defender. To clean up Mascherano, who's reasonably slow, but Danny Carvajal's done well in the end. And there's a player we can play it over to here. It's Rafa Varane, who's going to feed it to Carvajal. Vitolo, sorry, but Moreno got on that shit. Schweinsteiger to Herrera. It's good. Interception here by Danny Pereira. No Augusto. It's to Angel Correa, who's got plenty of pace. Angel. He shrugs them off. Doesn't give a shit, Angel. He feeds it to Aspas, who should have finished it. Oh, went the wrong side of the keeper there. For sure. Decent ball. Karius has got a touch, though. But Johnny keeps it in. He's going to whip it back in. Oh, what a clearance that was. Crucial. Rafa Varane wins it. Correa, but Ramsey's got a cross. Depay. Is Alberto Moreno. Schweinsteiger giving it straight to Correo. Vitolo onto Augusto. He feeds in a spas. He's plenty of pace, this card. Little skills, got him ahead. Clearly too close to Karius, though. Need to work on the crossing a bit. Yeah, Hector Bellerin gets lucky there. Look at the pass. It's deflected out for this guy, but we've certainly made the better start here. Torreira. Good ball, though, to Remy.
Good forward play from them.
It's the look, Remy. Oh, what a pass that is. To Sane. Oh, completely undeserved victory. Victory, what? Completely undeserved lead. So, hopefully it doesn't go on to become a victory, but... Credit to the assist. That was brilliant. I do think Lopez should have done better. But as you can see, it's actually counted as an own goal. His touch was so weak. But... really, we just switched off for a split second, unfortunately. And it was pretty incisive, the ball in. It's now Aaron Ramsey. It's muscled off it by Pereo. Johnny looks for Marcelo. He's found Johnny again. Good football, boys. That's Bass. Iago. Fight. He's still got it. Go on, Iago. Getting involved. Schweinsteiger sees it out. So Herrera. Remy. Look, Remy's caused me all sorts, really. Sane, pretty ball, but Mascherano almost surrendered possession again.
Well, here comes the counter charge now.
Spass. There's the ball to Vitolo. Vitolo, great pass to Augusto. He's come away for twice. Oh, what a save. Karius is saving these right now. Made three or four good saves in this game. Remy is really quick, but so is Rafa Varane. Deals with that well. Now it's Marcelo. Fernandez. Vitolo. Correa. Oh, unlucky Angel. Well played, Marcelo. Plays a lovely ball over the top. To Angel Correa. Oh, just as he goes for the shot. Great defending by Joel Matty. Seems to take him a while to actually take that down a stride. What? Goal kick. Jeez Louise, I thought he got something on that. Tackle again, put in by Augusto. Decent ball to Vitolo. That's Correa. Looks to turn inside, but numbers killed me a bit there. Schweinsteiger. Ball, ball. Marcelo feeds it to Pereo. Looks for Johnny. Johnny. Back to Pereo. Correa. Over the top to Vitolo. He went for it. We're dominating possession, dominating the passing stakes, but his one shot, he's been ruthless with. So right now we need to be a bit more cool in front of goal. But this is decent football. Oh, we've completely ripped him apart. There's Johnny. Hector Bellerin, fuck you. He's so quick. Now it's Schweinsteiger. Oh, we're all over them here. Miss attack. A spas. Oh, Hector Bellerin again. The crucial challenge. How is this 1-0 to him, really? Sane. Well played, Marcelo. Not only gives the ball, he keeps it in. And we found it back to him. Still Marcelo. Well, Hector Bellerin's there again. Been man the match so far in this game. Arguably. Terrible play up by them. He's giving it to Correa. And we have another injury. And this one's a player that we have to take off, unfortunately. So Vitolo's going to have to make way. Really? There's no one on a here I want to particularly bring on? Because Kevin might get tired. But it'll have to be Kevin. Dybala's on a loan, so I'm definitely going to bring him on. Yeah, the others can wait for now, at least. Perhaps later on I'll make some more subs. But we get the ball back here, and as we approach half-time, I do think we are going to be unlucky if we head in at 1-0 down. Hopefully we can carve out one more chance here. As Carvajal gives to Correa. Pereo is looking inside for Carvajal again, but they've got the ball here. Found De Herrera. Depay. Schweinsteiger. Bastian almost finds Remy. Oh, Diego. That wasn't good enough, but what was the clearance by then? As Kevin comes away. Do it for me, Kevin. Espas. Correa. Look for Espas. Diego, you're in form, mate. Come on. He seemed like he was past the man then. And, pretty sure it wasn't Bellerin, so there's no excuses for getting chugged off a day. He's got decent pace in form of Espas. With the card I've got on him, I think it should be 87. And he certainly should have buried one from there. So as you can see, I mean, according to this, they've had no shots on target, which of course is false. I don't know, maybe it wasn't actually. That would probably annoy me more if it turned out to be going off target before Lopez whacked it in. But we have a 5 shots, 3 in target, and a 1-0 down, unfortunately. So the referee's happy. I have seen enough to suggest that we can get back in this game and even win it. If we carry on what we're doing, so I might actually go ultra attacking to try and force this. As Schweinsteiger picks it up. Great challenge by Danny Pereira though. Can't get away first time, but he can second. Now it's Espas. Surely to finish. Iago. Oh, that's not good enough, Iago, but Angel Correa is there. Get in, Angel. Well, he bails out a strike partner there. Really should have done better with Espas. Again, Loris Karius having a decent game. It's a decent hand to it, but unfortunately for him, Angel's pretty damn quick. He ate up the ground to get in space. So, a perfect start to this half. I'm going to have assurance enough now to just go attacking rather than ultra attacking. Because we will leave spaces behind if we go ultra. It's a decent run there by the lad, but great challenge by Rafa Varane, who's been absolutely scythed down. And their player's going to get a buck in here. Number 5, it's Ander Herrera. It was not the best of challenges. Carvajal. Augusto. Back to Danny. Cuts inside. Needs a nice ball through to Danny Pereira. Oh, it's Bass. Had the right idea, actually. The player read it. Trying to cut back inside. Danger is 3-2. Crucial tackle by Varane on Sane. Love that, Varane. Plays off to Johnny. Now it's Marcelo. Who has pace. He's going to look inside here. Oh my god. Should have been a better ball there by Marcelo. But Ramsey's giving it away again to Pereira. Kevin. Give it back to Kev. Bang that, Kevin. Do it. Oh, De Bruyne. Get in, lad. That's why we bought the inform. Kevin makes an impact there. The super sub. I think it was an assist for Correa, who's having a pretty solid game. And this guy's doing something. I guess it's a sub, but I'll be surprised if he quits. So, didn't intend to do this, but whenever they do offer it up, I might as well. So, I'm actually going to bring... I'm going to take Espas off, because he has actually been disappointing. Bring on Roberto Firmino, who's currently not playing in the Premier League team. And I'm working on a Brazil setup right now, where Firmino will... definitely feature more. Very frustrated. Yet you wouldn't have expected that kind of gap between these two. They deservedly lead. So we'll see what change he's made. If it comes, it might have just been a formational change. This is better from this guy. So he has made a change. Shaka's just come on for Schweinsteiger. Oh no, he's tackled me in a dangerous position here. But he got greedy. And yeah, Diego Lopez might have been slightly at fault for the goal, but you're not going to beat him from there, lads. Oh, Danny Pereira. Just absolutely roasted them. It's going to be a booking. It's just talking to for Granit Xhaka. It was a bit of a dirty challenge, so, to be fair. I'm playing Hatchet Men today, I swear to God. No, I'm really on. Let's go far. Worked out in the end. It's De Bruyne. Wins it. Carvajal does well to keep it in. Now there's balls on. Again for Kevin. Far post, Kev. Great ball. Oh, Loris Karius is there though. Hector Bayer in. Feeds it to Ramsey. Skips past the man. Good ball as well by Ramsey to Xhaka, his Arsenal teammate. Rafa Varane's on that shit. Now it's Diego Lopez. Carvajal. Go on, Daniel. Roasted them there. Carvajal gives it to De Bruyne.
Just working away to try and find an opening.
Oh, Kevin. What's a run? It's come out to Pereo. Banging at Danny. Oh. Could maybe shot earlier of Kevin, but I was looking to go past that last man where he sort of checked him. But wasn't far away from Pereo. Good save in the end by Karius. Now it's Mascherano. And taken out somewhat. Marcelo picked it up. Marcelo looks for Kante. Firmino back to Kante. Great block in the end by Squadman Mustafi. Now Tramsey and Herrera. Xhaka picks it up and Sané's going to run. There's plenty of pace. He's looked for Lokremi, but a red dot. Here's the ball, Johnny. He's found it to Firmino. Oh, it's offside, I think. Kante. A million miles away. It was offside, but really like a split second. And he's making another sub. Just do them at once, son. That's generally what I do. So, all around, it's been a decent episode so far in terms of results, if we hold this, of course. Needed the two out of two, and certainly on course right now. So, I'll be confident going into Division 7 that, in respect that, you know, we may well win the title, having lost two games. Firmino to seal it. Oh, yeah, it's done as well. Lovely from Roberto. The first touch was key there. He just completely took the man up. I mean, poor work from my opponent, so he really gave it away softly there. But the touch from Roberto really was delightful. Almost give it away there. Depay gives to Henderson. Depay. Well, in Kante. What a beast he is. Now it's De Bruyne. Now there's a ball on its side. It is Firmino. Football, but when his touches are brilliant. Lovely Firmino. Johnny. Man, get Johnny. Oh, straight to Karius. But finesse on that one, I really shouldn't have, to be honest. But hindsight's a wonderful thing. You know, Depay's picked it up. Carvajal. On that. Kante to Firmino. Plays it back to Marcelo and Johnny. And we have plenty of men forward here. And they're struggling. Win that, Kevin. Unlucky, Kev.
Well, barring an absolutely enormous shock, he does look that way, and I think
Pereo.
Value the way they played this season.
Carvajal's going to whip this in. He has done. Oh. Well, it was a bit of a strange clearance from Bellerin. Can we win that? Oh, my God. Bit of pinball in the area there.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Pereo.
Marcelo.
Good football, boys. Varane. Correa. Blocked by Moreno. Really should have scored more than two in this game. Might do here with Kante. They say that, I've forgotten. I've actually scored three. But defensively, this guy's actually even been more suspect than the last guy we played. Really have been completely on top. Ball in for Varane. Saved by Karius again. It was a bit of a camera save. It was certainly easier than Karius made it look there.
Marcelo.
Nice from Johnny. Oh, he's gone past two.
Here's a chance to attack.
Oh, Johnny. Still got it. He's whipped it in. Punched away by Karius. Sané looks inside to Xhaka. He's over on it. Danny Pereira's on that shit. Bit lucky there as we fed the ball short, but he come out for it again. That's much better. Johnny's got it. Now it's Marcelo for four. It is four. Get in, boys. That's the biggest win in quite a while. And we're doing my favourite celebration, the homer. And wow, really goals from all over the shop here. Four different scorers, I think. So this guy really wasn't all that, to be honest. I will stress that. The last two opponents I've played, you know, you can just tell whether someone's suited for a high division or not. And the last two opponents I've played really are going to struggle getting out of Division 8, to be honest. But we were completely dominant. You can only beat what's in front of you. And you can see there, Angel Correa to 9.6, Marcelo 9.2. They were the best players in the game. And, wow. 4,000 coins for getting up. To be fair, I think the coin rewards are better this year than they were last year on Ultimate Team. Because that seems really decent to me. But, yeah, despite the fact that this guy was clearly destined for a long time in this division, we really did completely dominate him. So, you know, you've still got to do it. And we had 15 shots, 13 in target. You had 3 and 1. We had more possession. I don't think he had a shot in the whole second half, to be honest. So, really happy I've played these two guys, to be honest. Because it was cutthroat time with the two DNFs. As you can see, we have won the title, so we keep our record going. I think we've won titles in each division so far. So yeah, we still did play 3 games and lose in that division, which is concerning. Two opponents really completely outplayed me, to be honest, including the one that was the lag last time. However, I am still really confident going into Division 7 that we can get out of this. The one downside, as you can see, is that the point requirements have gone up. So we need 17 now for the title and 14 for promotion, which seems to me actually to be slightly up on last year. You know, I'm pretty sure Division 7 last year wanted lesser requirement to go up. I don't know, maybe that's me just not recalling properly, but we have 8 points to hold the division, and I'm going to try and smash through this as quickly as possible, really, because as I mentioned on a previous episode, I actually I'm working on something on the squad building challenge that is Alessandro Del Piero. So I still have 14 days left, 2 weeks to get this Alessandro in, but the problem is that the one I'm still working on, this is just solid. As you can see, I have one Sydney FC player right now, is this guy, Bobo, who's the only one that's relatively cheap on the market. Because if you search for Sydney FC players, and the last time I searched was about 2-3 days ago, so I'm going to guess it's still similar. They are really expensive, just because, of course, this is going on, and you know, anyone who gets it is just holding everyone to ransom right now. So I'm best going the other way. Sydney FC, there we go. Bam, bam, bam. You can see what I mean. These guys, you know, this right back is just 58, he's going for like 8,600. So it's one of these. I actually regret starting this. I'll be honest, because I did not anticipate them being this expensive, so I thought maybe if I hold on for like the last 3 or 4 days, it will get cheaper because more people might have completed it. Like, actually, this guy I'm gonna put a bid in because 2009, if we can get him for that, that'd be a miracle. So, yeah, where is C fit? I am gonna try and put bids in for these boys, and just hopefully meet the requirements, because thankfully the requirements aren't too bad in terms of the overall rate. But I mean, here's the example of what I mean as well, about being bad. You see in the same place, you know, that say the CDMs and stuff, they'll be off the market within minutes, I think. The only two guys that are relatively cheap are both strikers. So, you know, all I'm seeing right now is Calver and this guy. Really, anyone who completes this challenge for Del Piero does deserve to have him, because I think it's pretty tough. So I'm not going to give up, but I'll reassess, I think. I'm definitely going to wait a week or so and just see if they do go down. You can see our bid's been better there, so perhaps I'll look at what it's at now. Maybe put another one in just before this game, but I'm not going to wait on it, you know, all 7 minutes, to be honest. I'm there. Alright, I'll up it to 4, then I'm not going to put another one in. Now, the other one I have to complete is still got a fair few players left to go, but it's not really that hard to fill, I think, Calcio B. I mean, that'll only cost me about 2k max to complete that one. And the reason I did want to consider finishing this is because naturally at the start when I come in this, I thought, alright, I'll do the harder ones first, not knowing Sydney FC would be the most expensive. So, you know, looking at the requirements in here, I offered good players. I got rid of really good players. I signed Benatia, who'd have been starting for my Serie A team, and offered him up for this one. And I lost a good few players for the Italy team as well, including Donnarumma. So it will be a shame if I can't complete that one, because I did lose some good players, but I've learned my lesson. From now on, I'm going to thoroughly search each requirement before I make a start on any of them and decide whether it is worth it or not. So I got an injury for Vitolo. Four matches out of the upper body. The good thing is, actually, that I might just leave Vitolo on the side for the four games. You know, I'll put him on the bench for the Premier League team. On the reserve, sorry. Because I have another option that is Orellana. Hang on, I'm pretty sure I have another one as well. I don't know where Munain's gone, but I do have another La Liga player who could do a job here, I think. So, try and find this. La Liga, where are you? There we go. Oh, maybe I sold him? Shit. Unless he's on the bench and I've just not even looked. That'd be pretty bad. No? Holy shit. Wow. I must have already sold one in the market. I have one in the transfer market right now, so I might actually recall him. Good job I've not listed this. Right. Here he is. It's Inaki Williams. I don't know why I said money. I was thinking of a different Bilbao player. So as you can see, his pace is rapid. Like, he's worth doing this centre club. That Uruguay one, I'll just list again, but clearly it's not selling because I'm doing that, so I'll list it for its base. There are a lot of other players I could sell, but generally I will sort of keep hold of them for the squad building challenge. We've been outbid again, as you can see there. It's a 4-1. Alright, you know what? Might as well go 4-2 then. But I do still think I'll miss out on that one. That'll probably end up going for about 8k at least. So, just a brief catch up there on how I am getting on in that squad builder challenge. So, we're just going to hop straight back in the game now. I'm really eager to get the game through quicker now in the next few days, because we had a week where the connection was so bad. So I'm considering using a setup I've not used before. The Brazilian one still needs work for centre backs, to be fair. The Portuguese team's not quite there either, I don't think. I'll tell you what, it is, really. The only issue is Mascherano is playing at 4. So, yeah, I mean, there was no one else who seemingly would fit in so well. I just put him there, and he's only a 4 because the Argentinian connection with Lopez. However, there might well be a better alternative somewhere. So it's 100 chemistry for them, so it's difficult to tell, but, you know, off heart, I mean, I'm looking through. And it doesn't look like there's going to be anyone who fares any better, to be honest. No Portuguese guys or anything like that there, so. Oh, Liganos. Oh, I have Luis Al. What the fuck? How did I not notice I had Luis Al? Unless I just really recently packed him. Oh, God. Maybe that's why I didn't put him in. He's got 35 pace, which is just embarrassing, to be honest. So this is a risky setup if I play as these boys. I have two quick fullbacks, which might save me. And Julio Cesar's decent in that, obviously, so I might risk it. I might use these. Reason I want to use them is that because I have a premium edition of this game, which is the most expensive one. So one of the perks I get is that I have free match team of the week loan players, two of them a week. So I've hoarded these. I got Brian Ruiz about 3 weeks back, still haven't used him. I got Bernardo Silva as well from Monaco, who's just getting in Ten Campestre now because he's got the Portuguese connection for all these boys. Then I got Jota from Porto as well. So looking through, it's a really slow spine to my team, actually. Jota's the quickest at 80 and no one else is particularly fast. So it's going to be difficult really to do much with these guys, I feel. But hopefully them in-form wingers do well. I mean, on rating, this team is actually fairly solid at an 81. So William Carvalho in particular is going to be crucial for the centre-back position, I think. At 82 defending and 85 physical, hopefully he can protect Luis Al. But of course, if anyone does get behind Luis Al, I'm fucked pretty much. So hopefully we keep a tight seal at the back. There we go. Free latency for every game so far. I'm you know, you won't believe how delighted I am to see that. After spending the best part of 2.5 hours in last week just battling, trying to get in games and only succeeding twice and then losing one of them, it's been really annoying. So good to see. Now, in this game, we face an all-French team. Ah, they got Paul George and Tep, who's in my career mode right now at Bournemouth. French lad, I'm not sure who that is. But there's Fakir. I think that's Alessandrini. Jan Kabay is there. Mature. Adorami. Didn't really finish the rest of the team. But a good two or three of them I don't recognise, I'll be honest. And welcome to Wembley Stadium and welcome to Alan Smith. So it's Portugal plus a few Brazilians and an Argentinian. Well, here is the team sheet for the home side. Mind you, I have half a Portuguese team. It's pointless even mentioning the Portuguese outfit because, of course, I have Brian Ruiz as well. But my Portuguese league hybrid here against this French team. Let's see how we get on. Good start here. Possibly Adrian Silva. It's a terrible shot, though. But the danger is there. Here is Paul George and Tep. I know what he can do, of course, for Bournemouth. George has fed a lovely ball through to Nabil Fekir, who's gone through. Nabil, good challenge by Zigala. That's Brian Ruiz. Fed it to a guy who's been caught, but William Carvalho's on that chip. Ball back across by Brian. We're going to look to build to Bernardo Silva. The guy read the ball, but he still couldn't do anything about it. Got my cheers on this. I do have a feeling this guy's going to be much better than the previous two, of course. So he might actually have a game on here. Oh, Bernardo Silva's read that. Well done, Bernardo. Jota has found him again. Oh, it's offside. It's so unfortunate because Diego Jota was about to have a free shot on goal there. Keeper's gone short to Jeremy Mature. It's Dabo. Ben Yedder, that was the Seville player. Just signed in summer. Lovely work by Remy Cabella there. Good forward play from Fekir. Look right inside. Fekir looks on. Luis Al. Oh my god, Luis Al. He got caught. Julio Cesar bailed us out there. I think it was in Tep with the sliding shot. Put the ball in. Free header for Dabo. Well, not going to be Julio from there. Oh, great throw out. And brilliant work by Diego Jota to take it on. Never quite had the support though, Jota, and Cabello got packed to deal with that. Mature feeds it on. The touch has helped it on to Ben Yedder. He skips past, feeding Dabo. Thankfully it was Leandro Lopez who was back and he had the pace to get back into position to make the challenge. That's Colo, Cabella, goodbye. Johan, oh my god, what an effort that was. Zigala. So this guy's definitely made the better start here to this game. Ryan Ruiz. Well, we could be in here. Brian teammate. Can get past. Oh, lucky Brian. Really, there's no pace to this team, so I do need to have much more space if I'm going to get well behind here. Him. Good play, Luis Al. Challenge in the block has led straight to Fekir, but Zigala's done well there. Well done, Zigala. Silva. Jota to Silva. Back to Jota. He's going to look over to Brian Ruiz. cut it out. And Step Paolo almost got on there. Lucky Paolo. Goodbye to Cabella. Now Dabo. Fakir. No, where they're going. They're going to look wide. So red dot. Well done, Ziegler. There's ball on. 12 on to Brian. Brian Ruiz. Still going. Come on, Brian. Lucky lad. Ben Yedder drags back, looking for the run of Fakir, but he can't. Ziegler's on it again. Now it's Carvalho, giving it away. Bit of a midfield battle right now, where we'll cancel each other out. Both sides just threatening to get in behind. One of my players tripped each other up there, but played out in the end. So far we're looking... Oh my God, just about to say that. We're looking like we've calmed down a bit. After a dodgy start, and we have given away a corner there, which is silly. It's all led from that Julio Cesar kick out. So it's going to be Coach here. 60 corner. What is he doing? Are we facing a really OP header of the ball, perhaps, coming on? Maybe making a sub just based off this corner. So you talk about your specialist, if that is the case. But general impression so far in this game is that... Get rid. Yeah, general impression is that this guy can play, but I do think I can play through him as well. That's unfortunate though. He made the throw into Diego Jota. He's just sort of flicked it on and out. So it's Colo, Dabo. George. Oh, great ball by George. He's been a difference so far. Ben Yedder, he's going to finish. Oh, I knew it. So, he did break it away in the end. And the lack of pace killed me a bit. I'm not really feeling this Portuguese setup right now, I'll be honest. Yeah, still plenty of time to go in this game, of course. So I'll be happy if we can get back in, but we certainly have better setups elsewhere. I might consider using the Serie A one again. I almost ran all the way through there, though. Colo was last man. Dealt with it. Well, Dabo was found. Ben Yedder. Good ball. Oh no, Luis Salas the only one back. Well done, Cesar. Oh my God. How unlucky would that have been? Headed by Dabo. Flicked on by me, man. I mean, I got lucky in the end that it didn't go for a corner. But that was just mayhem. Flicked on by my own player. It's decent reflexes by Julio Cesar. Really owe him a favour there. Ziegler. Go on, Mario. Love that. Brian Ruiz. It's over. Ronaldo Silva to Jota. Oh, Diego. What a goal that is. That was a sick finish there. I did not expect that, I'll be honest. I thought, well, I might as well go for it. But, well, the three Team of the Week loanees involved. Oh, fairness. I might have took a deflection that one. I think it did take the slightest of deflections. And it really did, like, come off as close to the post as possible, where it was like to go in then. Like right in the edge of that shit. But that's a platform to build on here as Bernardo Silva goes free. Shrug him off, Bernardo. He has done. Go on, lad. Looks inside. Oh, and Joss has come away. Diego. Get on that. Oh, Carvalho is the one who reacts to the danger quickest. He whips out our trademark celebration. The captain for the day. Get him, will you? Wow, what a turnaround. Two goals in like a minute, really. He's probably going to make a sub here. But it's this midfield, really. They're like the main thing of this setup. The defence is actually reasonably weak in terms of rating and performance. We have some subs on, of course. I mean, Bruma's rapid. Let's check him out. He's got 94 acceleration, 92 sprint speed. Of course, we won't be sacrificing Brian Ruiz, but you tell you what, fuck this. I'm going to stick Bruma on up top instead of Paolo. And for chemistry purposes, alright. I've run out of time, to be fair. But I might take bring Pereira on at some point as well, because I think I only put Pinto on for chemistry purposes, and Pereira is certainly better. Carvalho's fed a lovely ball into Brian there. Go for the chip. Oh, I was asking too much in it. Wow, I did not notice actually. They've got another of our Bournemouth players there in Benoit Costa, who's my goalkeeper currently in my career mode. Oh, it's a wonderful turn up by Remy Cabella, by the way. He's still going. Remy, oh, what a goal. Fair play to you, mate. He should have stopped him with the second man, don't get me wrong, but that was a good goal, to be fair. Lewis Howe just runs off there terribly. Went in for the slide there, but couldn't quite cut across. That was a decent finish, so I cannot blame my opponent that time, actually, for watching a replay. So, entertaining half. We've had more possession. This guy's had 10 shots and 7 on target, my 4-4, though, so yeah. Yeah, it's been the better team, I'd say. But this team is probably my fifth or sixth strongest right now in the first game, Division 7. Against Sky, who's clear half decent. I'd actually take a point, so I'm reasonably happy with the half. And as it is, I do still think we can win this one. So through now with Bruma. Brought one for his pace. This is what he can do. Bruma. Still one away. Jota. Oh, that's a corner for us though, I think. So it's going to be Brian Ruiz. Whips this one in. Former Fulham man. Lewis Al. Oh, he said that over. That's like the one reason you're in the team, Lewis Al. Because your presence is set pieces. And you fucked it with him. I'm really annoyed with myself there. I should have scored that one. It's Dabo. He likes to skill buttons this guy. And I struggle to defend him. That's Dabo. Shows and Ben Yedder cuts inside, but Lissandro Lopez is on that one. Just going to wait for it and wait for it. There's the ball to Brian. Yeah, we challenged by Coach here, but it's tend to end a bit right now. Bruma. Lovely Bruma. Oh, Wilfred. I love that. Is it Wilfred? I don't know, but that was lovely work by him to really put on a play for Diego Jota. Super sub. Strikes again. Second game running here, boys. Challenge by Adrian Silva. Bruma. Jota. Bernardo Silva. Jota. Back to Bernardo. Oh, we're all over them here. What a goal this will be if we can finish. Jota. Oh, crucial block by Courtier. The 1-2. Took it past about five of their men then. They look dangerous on the attack as well. George is almost in. Great work by William Carvalho. It's a challenge, not once but twice. And Fakir, we give it away though. Held it a bit too long. Now it is Fakir who gives it to George. Oh, George has caused me problems all game. Not Tigalar. He's been the only defender to do himself justice in this game, really. And Ruiz gives it away to George. Wins it back, well done, Brian. Nice atonement. It's Carvalho. Bruma. William. It's a Jota. Good work, boys. Now it's Brian. Oh, Brian. That's insane from you. Whip it in. Brian to Jota. It's 4-2. Get in. Wow, this second half. We really have been a better team. It's been all change, I think. And to score four with these boys. I'll be honest, I'm not all of a sudden going to change mind. I do still think they're a bit of an unbalanced team, but well, going forward, they are a threat. I really do like this Jota a lot, I'll be honest. So maybe I will end up making a Portugal team and utilising some of these boys. Bruma. Bruma has been amazing. This could be five. Oh, Benoit Costa with the save. So I'm going to feed this short. If you look. Brian looks at Bernardo. Bernardo's just done them there. And he's fed it in to Jota, who wins the header. It is five. Wow, this is game over now, I think. What a second half. There's been 3 goals in 20 minutes. And it was all about Bernardo Silva, really. He completely did the man. Fed the ball short. I knew what I was doing. I sort of intended to do that. And he played it just as I wanted him to, by getting suckered into thinking I was going to cut inside and free up play there. Oh no, Bruma. What have you done, mate? You've taken this game by the scruff of the neck. He's still going. Bruma. Still. Bruma. It's Adrian Silva. Could maybe have been a pen. But they'll play on with Costa. He only gives as far as Carvalho. Bruma deserves this goal. Oh, he's got it. It's 6-2. This guy's just capitulated this half. Seriously. Holy shit, though. I really do need to learn this, who this guy is. Bruma. There he goes again. He just skips past. He doesn't give a shit. Dabo got on it in the end. Fakir. Brian Ruiz. Oh, the skill button by Bernardo. Silva. Cavalio. Oh, we're really clicking into gear now, boys. Zigala. Bruma. Crucial block, but it's not out too far. I do feel like this is the episode where we've arrived on the online scene. My record hasn't actually been as good as I'd wanted it to so far, but this half in particular, we've been so dominant. This could be 7. Silva, it is 7. Wow. This is easily our biggest win so far, and this guy is clearly playing an all-out attack and just being exposed, I feel.
Well, there is a big difference between these two teams, and that goal has meant it's reflected in the scoreline. I think it's going to be a stroll.
He's playing on then, fair play to him. This George goes on the run. George. Lopez tackle, but he still comes out of it, George. Good way there. Win it back, boys. Well done, Adrian. He's been beast, Adrian Silva. Bruma gives it to him. Adrian, he's going to go on. Oh, it's got to be. Probably not a red, to be fair. I was going to call for a red for a second, but I do think a man may well have been covering. Yeah, there's a booking in the end for Christian Cabaselli of Watford. The way this game's been going, I might as well just fucking go for it. Everything's been flying in this half. Can we do it again with Bryant? No, straight to the wall. As it is, actually, he might well get a goal here. Because he's on the break here with Ben Yedder. Lewis Howe waits and waits. Oh, he tries to strike. He's given away. Good save, Julio. So I think that was the first shot on target. Oh, there's the second. Good save again by Zazar from Mature. Yeah, it clearly can cause me problems at times going forward, this guy, but the problem for him in this half is that he's barely been out of his half. And really has struggled defensively. He's come away with it again there, though, with Cabella. He's dribbling nicely. Goodbye. Big block by William. Over a kick attempt by Kabay. That was outrageous. Bernardo Silva. Jota. Big tackle by the opponent, Fakir. Well done, Julio. So I'm going to look out for Zigala, who's got Brian in support. Go on, Brian. Oh, Brian, he's made it. That was a ball onto Bruma at the second attempt. Oh, Bruma, have you missed that? It's all right now, I suppose, in the context of the game, but. Well, that was a bit of a terrible open goal miss there, to be fair.
Well, they've got the ball back now.
Lewis Sal. Cavalio. Lucky Jota. George has pace. Not going to catch him. He's going to look inside, I think. What a tackle that is, Lisandro Lopez, you beast.
Well, here we can see the corner count so far.
Winnerada, well done, boys. Bruma. Well, second half was the best half I've played, probably, on this series. I think we won that 5-0, so really huge second half. As you can see, quite rare to do that as well. Diogo Jota played a 10. All around, they were beasts, actually. I think the defenders were perhaps rated higher than they should have been. Pinto's the only guy who rated less than an 8.9 outfield, except for Paulo Henrique, of course, was sacrificed and proved to be the best decision. From now on, if I'm going to use this side again, Bruma is definitely starting up top with Jota. So, goals-wise, Jota got 4. He is in form, and wow, he showed it. He's right up there amongst mid club's top scorers, probably already off top. Bruma got 1, Carvalho got 1, Adrian Silva got the other. Assists, 2 for Bernardo Silva, 1 for Brian Ruiz, 1 for Carvalho, 1 for Bruma, and 1 for Jota. So, Jota was directly involved in 5 of them, 7 goals. Absolutely a card I'd recommend based on that performance. That was dynamite by Jota. This guy, all his shots were in the first half, as you saw. It was really was a game of 2 halves. We had 16 shots in the end, so it was 14. 13 in target, so it was 10, and more possession. So, he edged the first half. Probably, I'd say, 60-40, but the second half was really like 90-10 to us, so we definitely deserved that one. We have to win and start in Division 7, so 3-1 top 3 for the episode. I'm happy. That's going to be it for this episode, I think. So we'll follow with another episode where we play another 3 games. So that's usually the amount we'll do. And hopefully we keep this form going. I'm going to probably utilise... I've just realised, by the way, I did make a big mistake. I was supposed to put Vitolo on the side so it wastes one of his injuries out. So that's a shame. I'm not even going to look via that because it'll take ages because he's not rare. So yeah, we'll stick him on another team. So I have players here that are insane. One of the team of the weeks that I'm going to use next game is Milik, and it's one to watch. So if there is an inform Milik comes out, I'm pretty sure that means I get loan inform Milik for 3 games. So I figure I might as well wait and utilise a bit of Gabbiadini. Now, I don't have a steady left mid right now. This guy's been the best because he gives Dybala his 10 chemistry. So, yeah, the Serie A team needs work as well. So I think next episode I'm going to use some new setups, possibly the single one. So hopefully you join me then when... I tell you what, I quite like the look of the side. I'm going to use this one. That will be next episode as we look to maintain our form from this episode. So thanks for joining us for this episode, and I hope to see you again.